back with Chester head football coach Victor Floyd. His 14-0 Chester Cyclones will be playing Dillon for the 3A state championship on Saturday. First of all, Coach, congratulations on making it this far.
Well, thank you. Appreciate it.
At what point in this year, and it may have even come before this year, did you feel like this team had the potential to get where they are now?
Well, we actually thought we could be pretty good in the spring, but to be 14-0 now, I didn't think that. But I thought we had a shot to make a run during spring practice.
Obviously, you had a lot of returning talent, still young at some spots, but a lot of guys who did play last year. So that made the decision to hand the starting quarterback position to a true freshman. It may not have been tough for you, but what was it about Zan's makeup and what he had around him that made you comfortable handing the keys of the offense to him?
Well, the physical presence along with the arm talent, along with us having the guys up front, you know, I just thought it'd be the best combination. You know, taking nothing away from Stan. Stan's a good player for us, and we would have been fine with Stan, trust me. You saw that in two games where he played quarterback. But just the things that he brings to the table, ability-wise and the physical attributes, along with what we have up front, we thought it'd be the right combination.
The offense is a little bit different this year than it has been the last couple of years.
A lot different.
In some respects, a lot more ground heavy. You're using tight ends for the first time, I guess, since you came back, actually.
Right.
And an H-back that you use kind of like almost like a fullback. Was it just, you know, a matter of wanting to adapt to the talent that you had and make the best use of it?
That's it. I mean, as high school coaches, we have to be able to take what we got and make it work. And when we don't have a ton of receivers, then we have to figure out what we can do. And the best combination to allow those young men to be successful. And that's what it was this year.
Okay. And then you kind of, it seemed like, went out of your way this year to schedule a really tough out-of-region schedule. You made a trip to Georgia, you played Rock Hill, you played Fort Mill, you played Lancaster. Was that a conscious thing?
That was by design. I wanted to really max our kids out in our non-region and preseason schedules. Because if you look at our preseason, we scrimmaged Union and Ridgeview, which you know how good they were, and then Huff just got put out in North Carolina Friday night. So I wanted to make it as difficult as possible. That way we would grow in the process.
You actually mentioned Stan Mills.
Right.
He's a really good running back. He's run for over 1,000 yards. You use him in a rotation with, you know, with Felique and Emmanuel. But you kind of alluded to the fact that he had to step in and play the majority of the reps in a big game against Fairfield Central and then started a playoff game. That's a pretty valuable tool to have, isn't it?
Right, no problem. I mean, it was no problem for Stan. I mean, he was prepared for it, you know, just waiting the opportunity at quarterback. But Stan's played a whole lot as a sophomore, you know, started last year as a sophomore, started this year as a junior. He's played a lot of reps. He understands and knows kind of what's expected. And, you know, he's been practicing at that position all 3 years he's been in high school. So he took advantage of the situation and got us two wins.
And then your defense, you know, a little bit undersized. I think you said in the press conference a few minutes ago, maybe not any future SEC starters on the defense, but that's been as effective a unit maybe as there is in the state.
They have been very efficient. Our coaching staff, our defensive staff's done a great job with those young men. And the kids have done a great job buying in. I mean, like I said in there, I think it's more about heart, you know, especially on that side of the ball than it is anything. And those guys play with a big heart.
This is your second time taking Chester to a state championship. In your first tenure, you went there in 07. One of your assistant coaches, Coach Canny, was actually on that team. What kind of stuff is he imparting to these guys about what this week's going to hold for them?
Well, I think it's been a big plus because he did have an opportunity to go through that as a sophomore. So, you know, he saw it in the baby stages, very young. He was able to go through it, and he can share the experiences because we're still extremely young as a team, too. I mean, I brought 11 seniors here, and I think 9 of them start. So we're still young, and a lot of the guys don't know what to expect. And him being able to share, I hope, will be a big help for us this week.
People might be surprised to realize because they say, oh, well, Chester had 15 or 16 starters back this year. That the number of freshmen you started last year, especially on defense, you'll have your entire front 7 back next year.
Right. We were extremely young defensively. We get, you know, the backers back, the defensive line. we started a lot of freshmen sophomores last year. Out of those 15, 16 that we returned, there are probably nine of them probably freshmen sophomores, 9 or 10.
Turning to this Saturday's game a little bit, you're facing Dillon. That's just, right now, it's kind of a dynasty sort of in high school football. What makes them so good, not just this year, but on a year-to-year basis?
Well, I think it's the program they have in place, and they've had success, and the whole town's behind them, so they encourage players to play. They encourage kids to play football. Where we're in a society now where people discourage young men from playing football. They have a culture there now where it is cool, where they are having success, where kids are going to school. So it's become the end thing to do, and Coach Hayes has done a good job with that.
You mentioned in the press conference a little bit earlier that in 07 there might have been a little too much of a focus on just getting to state.
Right.
That once they got there, maybe it overwhelmed them a little bit. How do you – and because I'm sure everybody wants to pat them on the back and everybody wants to have a cookout for them and all that kind of stuff in Chester this week. Now, I mean, which you understand. But how do you kind of insulate them from that for this week?
Well, again, I think these guys – this group understands that focus has been our biggest thing. And, you know, in 07, I think everybody was content with going to state or just getting there because that's all you heard. This time around is totally different because there's more emphasis on actually winning. So I think from that perspective alone, the focus is a little better.
And this is totally unrelated to the 3A state championship game, but your alma mater will be playing for state on Friday night. You of course, played at Green C. Floyd, previously played on the best team in program history. I guess it would have to be assumed that this one has surpassed y'all in that respect. But
right.
Just how special would it be for you to see your alma mater win a state championship and then hopefully Chester win one on Saturday?
Well, I'm excited about that. Our community at home definitely needs that. And those guys have done a tremendous job this year. And, you know, Green C. Floyd is one of those places that people really don't know about, but there's always been talent there. I helped a young man go to college a few years ago who ended up being missing the Olympic trials, making the Olympics by one place, Calismo Newman. Nobody knew about the kid. He was down there at a 1A high school. But there's talent that runs through there, and I'm glad to get an opportunity to put it on display.